my first time doing this here at Evolution, and I couldn't be more grateful to be standing next to the one and only, oh, sitting next to the one and only, Mr. IFC Yipes.
Okay, I'm all right, but I'm actually glad that you're with me right now. You know what I'm saying? Latino heat in the building.
Oh, my God.
So we got some, this is going to be the final match of the 10 a.m. pool.
Okay.
So this is Suzuki Watanabe. I just wanted to say his name,
okay,
right? Suzuki Watanabe. That's a nice name. Shu, short for Shu.
Ah.
From Japan, taking on Everett McLeod.
I see.
And his name is E equals MC squared, I think. E equals MC. Looks like a smart one.
Looks like he...
Representing USA.
Like he majored in the sciences. I don't see him majoring in English.
He's a Mora player.
Ah,
I think so.
Cool.
Wait. Nah, he's a Thor player.
Okay. Well, you know, Doctor Strange is in there, so... And Thor.
So we got two doctors and the son of Odin running the point position.
And meanwhile, look at this other team.
This is just Mag Doom and special guest appearance by Virgil. This is pretty cool. Now, very, very solid team. Let's see if they have a very strong Magneto, Dr. Doom, Virgil. Okay, already starting it with the Man of the Blast. I like it. Yeah, you're a big Magneto player, huh?
Yeah.
So critique, please. Let me know.
Okay, so yeah. So here we go. So definitely he's trying to establish the pace of the game. Staying on the other side and waiting for that. Waiting to establish this right here. Yeah, just staying away. He's going to pick a shot. You know, facing these teams sometimes. That's interesting.
It's Thor.
I think that was one of those, you know, push blocks that we all love. Turn into a slide.
And then when you hit it, you actually like, no, I meant to do that.
Yeah. Your story changes.
See, your CJ shows up.
Nice block there. And here we go. We get started. Now, you critique this for us.
We're going to get some loot, baby. Oh, nice. Dash into fix that combo.
Wow.
He's a strange player. Definitely a strange player. Okay. This is definitely Dr. Strange's best assist for Dr. Strange right here.
Yep. Oh, he gets caught. And again, E equals me. Has X Factor available to him. Oh, on the meanwhile,
nice.
Look at all this.
Fixed it. Oh, but no combo there.
Now, tell the people out there, is that loop, you know, typically really hard? Or when does it start getting hard?
The only reason it's hard is because people's having trouble when they super jump and go neutral with the stick, then hit forward. Sometimes people kind of have this problem where they'll hold up forward, and that's not how you get impact form. You literally have to do forward fierce punch to get impact form. So that's the biggest issue. And you got to aim for the legs at all times. If you want to keep them up there,
right,
you got to aim for the toes all the time. And you can always keep them up there. Right. But with a little bit of practice, it's not that big of a deal. The practice is to actually learn how to play that character. This is a bad matchup.
Yeah. On top of that, he has X Factor available to him. This is going to be really hard for Shu.
I am loving this neutral right here. Oh, he's dead. X Factor, let me get the five-minute finish. Yes.
I like this approach by E equals me.
Oh, it's E equals me.
Is that what it is?
I think it is. You know what? I like that one better. Sorry.
Actually, you know, I think you were right from the get-go, though. I think he did mean to put MC squared.
It's all right.
All right.
Right.
Pretty unique.
E
either
equals
way.
Me. I take it. Don't worry about it, bro. If you win and you check out your matches,
yeah,
I gotta give you that name.
Ooh. Yeah. He will register the next tournament with that name. Ooh, nice hit confirm right there.
Wow. I rarely see Thor's use that. That was pretty good.
I think he got out. He got out.
Nah, if you want to keep it.
Nice. Oh, no. Yeah, the slide usually works on that super.
Don't know why he went for that, though. He should have just gone. If he really wanted to survive that, he should have just done Spell of Ashanti for X Factor.
Yeah. Yep. Or Sacrifice Thor, one of the two.
Okay.
Oh.
Get out of here with that. Can't get nothing off of it.
Oh,
but
I get a push block.
No, he did that one. He did on purpose.
Did it on purpose. Okay.
No, he didn't.
I didn't think
right.
So.
No, he didn't.
Oh, my gosh. This might take a while, folks. Or none at all.
Damn, that throw was efficient.
Yeah, okay, you can start to tell like there's a little bit of nerves happening.
Oh yeah.
Whoa.
I like that.
Okay.
That's good.
Yeah. Devil triggered him for an assist.
Have the upgrade. The extra the no miles on the car, Virgil.
Yeah. And the cool thing about it too is even if he gets even if Meat gets to him, he gets a double jump.
Damn, you're getting scooped.
Huh. Missed input right there.
I don't know why he didn't DHC there.
Oh.
That's a lot of confidence in that foot dive. All right, let me see something. Pressing up to the corner. Shu doing a really good job right now, keeping him away, fending him off.
Yeah. And I like this. I am a fan of this gameplay. Nice. Did not engage him unless it was safe. Properly called assist. Got out of the corner.
Don't even X-Factor. Show that you still have your... That is a dominant match.
I like that. I like that.
When you show that you still have all your resources, like, no need.
Yeah.
Straight up.
One of the people who I remember who used to do that a lot to psychologically tell his opponent that he didn't need it was Combo Fiend. He would beat people without the X-Factor intentionally.
Yep. Knowing he could have just finished the combo, but he extends the combo anyway. Damn, Doom's eyes is cataract. Better spend the rest of your days rotting away in prison and castle. You know, I don't get to see much of these. The rematch button gets hit so fast.
Yeah.
But that's actually the first time I actually read that.
I love the ones where like they have like a rival and they have a special message for them.
Yeah. Right, let me see this door. The door with bolts is actually what he should be using right here on the neutral. He should only be calling hidden missiles if they need to go in the air.
Yes.
Oh, nice night by then. Dr. Doom says, okay. E equals me is doing a great job right now in the neutral.
Nice. Push. Hit confirm right there. We should be getting some type of TAC. There it is. Okay, do you have these? Under pressure.
No jet lag here. Oh, a lot of jet lag. Keep away.
Yeah, and you know what? E equals me letting him know. You know, you have to respect me. I know my Thor. And I know you don't know Thor. Oh my gosh, other side.
That was pretty sexy.
I like this. I like when the character, when they pop out.
Did you get something from that?
Oh, I see.
I'm impressed.
Very pretty. Oh, but he misses it at the end. Yeah, and she's going to be looking for a way to get out soon.
Oh, he
said. Off a counter? Okay, no.
Here comes Virgil. Fend off all of these shenanigans.
Yes. Oh. What a wonderful way that Virgil comes in. Time to die.
He means it. Sometimes he means it, sometimes he don't. Oh, that's a free pickup.
I like that decision, getting rid of the problem right there.
Shouldn't waste any meters. He's good.
Nice.
Okay. Oh, this is going to do incredible. Oh, I thought he was going to move, man.
You know, E equals me playing so well.
He definitely is. Impressive play right here, I must say.
Yes.
And I like this team, though, too. I mean, granted, you got the Doom. Everybody plays Doom.
Right, but?
But you got the Thor, Doctor Strange, which gets you very excited.
Oh, he tried to grab him. He tried to X-Factor him to grab him. It didn't work out.
Ooh.
Wow, I like these mix-ups. He will call missiles and follow the missiles to attack safely, but he got caught. Oh, okay. What type of mix-up do we have? Okay.
Ooh.
Oh, he missed it.
He is keeping it mighty dry with Magneto, and he's hitting them too.
Yes. Oh my gosh, he got caught, and yeah, if he does the appropriate combo, this is over.
Yeah, he's dead.
But does he know the combo?
Oh, the launcher to disrupt the Tempest?
Yeah, yes.
We'll see.
He doesn't need it. Okay.
Shockwave, nice and easy.
And in a game that looked to be going E equals me's way, Shu snatches it back.
Yep. Shu putting in some work right now for the land of the rising sun. Neem already qualified, of course, so that's one representative.
Okay.
In the fray of American Marvel. So they definitely have a lot to prove this time around. Yeah. This is actually one of the most difficult evils, I must say, man, to win.
Yes. Everybody really came prepared this time. Everybody's hungry.
Everybody has gotten better over the years, so it's a good thing.
Yeah. And you know what? Yeah, exactly what you said. It's not just the technology. It's not just like the new characters that people wouldn't expect. People got better with neutral, you know, with their decision making.
Trying to understand, man. You got to space out sometimes.
Mm-hmm. Oh, nice triangle jump right there.
Okay. And Shu, I say we're going your favorite.
Up.
We're going on. Yeah. Oh, we're getting a snapback.
Okay. Oh, okay. Yeah, that would have been good. Oh, but he got caught.
Okay, creative is creating a space right now.
Wow, a lot of stuff on the screen. Hard to see, but he misses it.
Oh, man. I would have liked to see that crumble into the wave dash to the corner. Mm. I like that. Thor Strange.
Nice block. Yeah. Shu trying to maintain his composure through all of this. E equals MC has probably had a good 4 or 5 turns before Shu has gotten one.
Ever
popular foot that gets the point across. What is he going to do here?
Oh, he's going to finish. Definitely. Oh, okay.
Oh, Tiger need. Oh, no.
Oh, we get to Mantle Super. Oh.
Could he have grabbed him?
I think so. Mm. I don't know how fast it is, but maybe. I don't think it's fast like a bionic arm.
No, you cannot lose this character. This is your ace in the hole. Oh, my God. Yeah, he's going to make sure he doesn't have to deal with this.
Come on, bro. Thought he was going to go for that Dr. Strange DHC, but nonetheless, he got rid of the problem.
Nice DHC there. Yeah, this is going to be such a nightmare for Dr. Doom to deal with. Oh, my gosh. Whoa!
Good, respect. Respetamente. That was a great way to respect him right there. Sometimes, you know, you get a little overzealous, start pressing buttons, and then bam, dead character.
Done.
So you definitely got to have that awareness where you can live long and prosper. As you can see, E equals MC squared right now. Tied it up.
Okay. Live long and prosper. So good.
Oh, we got one of my favorite players. I mean, I don't know. We're esports, so I don't know if I could pronounce his name.
I'm
going to do it as esports as possible.
Okay, I like that. I like that.
All right.
A little bit of variation, no problem. I can't wait to hear this one.
I don't know how I'm going to do it, man, to be very honest with you.
Yeah, it'll be interesting. In the meantime, Shu gets the hit. It's 2-2, folks.
That was up, I swear. It was up. For the simple fact that Thor pointed up and knew that it was that's where he was going. So when Thor broke it, he had the hammer in the air. That was funny.
For Asgard.
I broke it.
Yeah.
Asgard.
Loki back at home is like, damn it. Yeah, she was trying to get out of this mess, and he's trying to find a clean opportunity to hit him, and he did. Ah, he knows a tag combo.
Definitely, if you play Mag Doom Virgil, any Mag Doom Berry, that is definitely one of the combos you need to learn to optimize and increase your chances to finish off a character.
Oh, what a mix-up. And he will do everything to get rid of this character. You best believe it.
Damn, I love your theme music so much, Strange.
Unfortunately, it will be cut short.
It definitely is going to be short. You know what? At least the horns hit a little bit.
Just to make sure. He doesn't want a DHC to Virgil. I like it. Well, as it often does, it comes down to your Dr. Doom. Ooh, okay. Little shuffle right there.
E equals MC definitely still has a chance there. What I would like to see is for the Virgil Assist to be called recklessly, and he just put a Spear Flame in Booty.
Ah.
That's what I'm waiting for. I hope that's what happens.
Ah, yeah, and he's trying to fish. He's trying to fish for, I don't know, for like maybe an assist. Or, you know, catch him off guard.
Oh, that could have been Shu was definitely aware of the situation, though.
Yeah. Yes. I like this by Shu. He's taking his time.
He's not testing that foot dive. I like it.
Nice. Jab into stand. Wow. We are brave today.
All right. We're going to go up and double teeth. No. And then X-Factor.
Yeah. It's enough, I think. Oh, my gosh. Oh. Sometimes it's challenging to activate it on the way up.
Yeah. It was pretty meaty, so understandable. Okay. And Shu moves on. Okay, that was the winner's finals, right? Yes, it was.
Wow.
Okay, so he advances. Okay.
The Japanese are looking to make a statement.
We end it. All right. So okay, let me see.
Oh yeah. This one, folks. This is the. This is gonna be interesting.
There's no way to esports this.
There has to be a way.
Look.
He is.
All right. Everybody knows the snake tits. Okay. All right. Everyone knows the snake tits. I try my best. I usually call them nipples. That's what I usually call them. That I don't know.
I like that.
Yeah, I used to call them snake nipples.
And the interesting thing is, like, they try to suggest a name to us. Doesn't matter. Right before we got the paper, you let them know what's going on here, guys.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know that could have maybe been clever. We have a snake t.it. I like what Yipe said. Definitely like what Yipe said.
I'm sorry, you know, man. I could have showcoded. This is Marvel. You know I got to keep it 100.
Absolutely. This is the real hype.
So I'm going to just call them Snipples.
Snipples.
just the snake.
I like that.
Yeah. Versus Matchui. My bad. I forgot that he had an opponent. It was all eyes on Snake. I'm going to just call him Snake. I'm going to call him Snake. Nah. I got a snake.
Yeah.
It is what it is. He looks like a snake with nips.
A very well-groomed snake. Congratulations to him as he got engaged.
Yes. Just came back from Hawaii. Yes.
Yes. Planned it all out. Had his family surprised the bride and everything. So congratulations to him. But right now, he has to get his competitive spirit against.
Oh, this is an annoying team by the nipples, man. We got beautiful Joe Dr. Doom hitting missiles, Virgil. Oh, my God. This team is annoying. I want to see what he's going to do with. Oh, he got Nova, Thor, and Dr. Doom. Man, we got a lot of variety nowadays.
You know, lately, though, I've been seeing an emergence of Thor. You notice that?
Yeah. Definitely seen a lot of Thor action up in the Curly, and I was seeing the Evo. Yeah.
Population used to be 1%. We're up to, I don't know, 13%.
Well, just to let you know, this matchup is terrible for Nova. It's one of his hardest matchups. Snake, though, he's not making it difficult. But he should definitely throw a lot more Ninja Star.
Yo, okay.
Oh, my God. What the?
Yeah, I know. You can definitely tell that Matt Chewy is a little bit nervous.
Interesting decision there. Flex with the X-Factor in the air. Came down, landed overhead. Wow. What an answer.
All right. And Snake Tits is trying to establish distance. Yep. This is the lane game he needs to play, as you said.
This is bad.
Well, he needs to make a decision. He needs to do something.
So the best way to kind of throw off the Beautiful Joe from being so comfortable is when you see the red, when you see the boomerang come in charge, you got to super jump towards him. Just to throw him
the rhythm.
I'm here. You know what you're going to do now.
Right.
One of those strategies. So he's going to have to apply.
And perhaps make a move and not keep throwing boomerangs. Yeah, that makes sense. Nice break there by Thor.
Okay. I don't know what Thor's gonna do here. I want to see something. Implemented in this game right now.
Oh. All right.
Try to hug him. Good attempt, but he caught two boots in the mouth for his trouble. Sucks, man.
What a move in this game that's become over the years. Oh, buddy. Okay. He's able to get out.
We were talking about the mighty foot dive.
Absolutely.
Yeah, man. It changes a lot of.
Got hit over the head with a dolphin kick.
Could have extended that combo a little more. Don't know why he did that one.
Yeah. I really think Matchui is suffering from tournament nerves right now. Let's see if he can adjust.
I like his name, though. Matchui. Wow. I'm for the string anyway, even though it did not connect.
Ooh, the soccer ball. Let's go.
Ooh.
Yeah, this is going to be really difficult. Why does that happen sometimes? As soon as I... Oh, my gosh.
You're just the curse. You're the curse. I thought I was the curse. You are the curse.
I mean, at Curly, I don't know. I think it went both ways. Oh, my gosh. The foot dive is getting turned into a buttercup, but he gets the grab. Yo, you know, he is one-hitted. Yo, this is happening like 4 or 5 times.
Man, Chewy, man. He's creative.
Oh, he went for it. We are in Vegas. He gambled it. Oh, my gosh.
Makes it, man. Been in the sun for too long, dude. That Hawaii. Thrown off your execution.
Again with the butter gun. He is definitely meaning to do foot dives right there.
All right, Nipples is going to have to step it up. Mad Chewy also. Chewy looks like he has a lot of tournament nerves. Snake is just looking.
And look at CJ. CJ's saying, come on, man.
He's like, bro, really? I'm going to miss a high time?
And then wants to confirm with Justin Wong that his advice to Snake Kiss was correct.
Yeah, I was saying earlier, CJ's advice is a 50-50 kind of thing. More so, you know, if I would give somebody advice, like a 70-30. 70% of the time, my coaching will work.
Sure.
You know?
Sure.
You know what? No. I shouldn't give CJ 50-50. That's actually too much credit. I would say...
Oh, gosh. What would be the correct statistic? You would
90-10. 90% being that he's wrong. It's a 90% ratio that his information is false.
And this is still appropriate credit?
Can you agree? You've been around more.
I was thinking like maybe 93.
Wow.
Nah. Wow. But CJ Showstopper, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh.
Wow.
Okay, look who cleaned it up.
Okay, okay. Yeah. That might be the 7% that CJ from time to time usually hits the nail on the head. And right now, Snake Tits. Oh, okay, okay. All right, Machu still has a chance. And folks, throughout this tournament, expect to see a lot of Doom Anchors because people don't want to deal with Virgils and Phoenixes and or Striders, all that nonsense. So usually, what will happen is the opponent will snap in the last character and kill him and try to deal with this character at the end.
Man, this is a commanding lead. You know what? I'm just going to go. Oh, wow.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, I'm going to go here and say this is 2-0, but you never know. This is Mad Chewy, okay? This is Mad Chewy. He's a madman. Things could happen.
And you know what? In this game with X-Factor, you are 3 hits away from victory.
At this point, yes. But yeah. the resources, is he's losing the mojo.
Yeah. Nice. I like that by Snake Tits. Not taking a chance. Yeah.
I see that you're trying to resist saying his name. Just let it flow.
You caught that. I'm
listen, man. Look, it's there. It's there.
In full color, mind you. Well,
now,
you know
if it was
what?
Something other than that, then yeah, I would just, you know, it's just.
That's him. That's him. I like that.
You know, let's think about. Yeah. Yeah. Take two. By Snake Tits.
Yes. Okay.
Yeah. I understand that you're trying to be professional here. Me too. Trust me, me too. But we just can't resist.
Absolutely. And they even put it up for us. You're right.
Yeah.
You're all right.
Yeah, we gotta just go with the flow, man. Because if we don't go with the flow, then we're just not flowing like the water, man.
And now Snake is doing an excellent job staying away. Yeah, you can tell Matt Chewy is a little bit flustered.
Yes, this is terrible for Nova, man. Like I said, he has to super jump. Or even random Supermans. It could actually work out.
Oh, like look at that pulse of victory. Landing the last hit. Nice mix up. Are we going to go for?
Just take it.
Nice block there.
If he's going to count on the anchor, should be Dr. Doom. Usually I just tag.
Yeah.
See what happens. But I don't know what the Beautiful Joe is thinking.
Beautiful Joe, in my opinion, one of the most underrated characters in this game.
Yes.
Look at all this work.
I actually put him in my top 8 range.
Oh, my gosh. That butter gun has been a big problem for Matt Chewy. Wow. Another overhead. And he's going to, great decision there by Snake Tits. He's going to make him guess. What are we going to do here?
Overhead. The classic. Oh, wow.
We are going to get a little bit of swag. I like this. And because he's in slow, Virgil is allowed to do what he wants. Look at this.
Wow. Damn.
Thank you, Snake Tits, for giving us a little something. I appreciate this. Look at this.
That works.
He able to get his swag on and sending Matt Chewy to the loser bracket. Yes.
That was cute. Hey, Snake, that was cute, man. All right, good stop there by Snake.
Okay.
I think, he just moves on his pool. I don't think that was winner's finals. But he's in there. Oh, we got Quasi Domo. Okay, cool.
Okay.
So we got Quasi Domo taking on GC Yoshi. I'm actually a very big fan of GC Yoshi.
Yes.
He plays that Chris Redfield, Spencer Sentinel team. Quasi Domo plays he actually has new variations, but he plays Dr. Doom, X23 Scroll, sometimes switches, I think, the Doom with Trish.
Yes, he
so
does.
So let's see what's up, though.
Yeah, and it's gonna be one heck of a match because those are the characters that, you know, it's not like you have a Magneto Doom, not Mora Doom, none of that nonsense. You have a variety of characters here.
Yep.
Let's see what happens.
Rare variety of characters.
Bring the pain, he says.
You know, I would think since the game has gotten more advanced that you would see more top tiers, but people are still sticking to their guns.
Yeah. GC Yoshi to
Guilty Gear. So that is what's up.
Oh, so GC Yoshi just got called up to Guilty Gear, and I think that because of that, we're going to have a different match.
Damn it. I wanted to see some shots.
Mm.
I wanted to see some shots.
Okay. So now, instead, for you guys, we had.
Oh, we got Koji Shimomura. Ooh, okay. I like their names. It's like, it's so anime, son.
Yes.
We got Koji. All right, Koji Shimomura, right?
Versus
TMP Cross from Japan. This is actually I'm telling you, versus 2-0.
And to be honest, I've been wanting to see Cross play.
AKA made game over.
Yes, he is regarded as one of Japan's best, if not the best, from Nemo himself.
Yeah, I'm hearing it's either Cross or
oh my gosh
or RF. Now
he's taking it old school. Look.
to the, right,
on the floor. Yeah, I like that. And usually people that do that in this game have amazing execution.
I heard Cross plays my old team. I'm not too sure if that's true. That he plays Spencer, Virgil, Hawkeye. I'm not too sure how true that is. That's what I heard from a couple of people. To be honest, I never seen him play.
Really?
No, I never. Have you seen him play?
I believe once before when we were gonna do like a, I don't know, like a match, and we walked in and he was already playing. From what I hear, again, Nemo said that he's probably the best right now in Japan. So let's see. This should be quite a treat for us, folks.
So I don't know if he picks that team though. I'm very curious. And if he does, I hope he motivates me. Don't know who made Game Over play.
I do believe that the masses do miss your Hawkeye, though. I will say that. I miss your Hawkeye.
Thank you, man.
Where is he?
After Evo, he's just in the back burner, man, with the Avengers. See, after Evo, I'm going to have to go revisit some old teams and see, okay, what happens.
Okay.
Drop the Nemo for a bit and go back to basics.
And, yeah, as you said, look at this. Captain America, Frank West, Sentinel. Yeah, people just... they want to stick to what they know.
They stick to their guns, like I said. Like I said, you would expect them to catch up with the meta and pick the advancement, but they want to stick around with that meta with their whole team.
Yeah.
Yes.
So here we go, and as you can tell, Cross is gonna do no unique team. He is going straight to the top tier and going
Zero
for that W.
May cry. Okay,
TMP
so
Cross.
You know, yeah, what? Definitely a very potent team. So I can see why Nemo would say that he's the best, but we're going to have to see it in his gameplay.
Yeah, and I can already tell, though, from the get-go, yeah, he's keeping his distance and picking his shots with Zero. That is the mark of a player who has fundamentals. Look at this. Yes. Stays back, and he's going to pick his shots.
I like that. He's very aware. Even though this is Captain America, Captain America got some nice little sleazy waves.
Look at that. Wow. Picked the perfect spot, gets the hit confirmed, and now, once he gets the hit, it's over, as he says.
Please report to your Guilty Gear.
In Japanese. I know exactly what he's saying. All right, here we go. Frank West, come on, Mel Gibson.
Nice block. Oh, but you are going right back to the corner.
Human, man, what can you say? What can you do?
Yeah.
What are you going to do?
But stare away.
Okay.
Yeah, Cross looking mighty strong right now. At the beginning of the round, actually, sometimes strength is not measured by how aggressive you are. It's by your movement and what the decisions that you did. And at the beginning, he didn't do anything. He just waited for the right shot. He got it. Look at this.
Sucio. Very sucio. Damn. Haven't mopped the floor for months.
Yes.
Like 5 months in, 6 months in, no mopping.
And Zero says, in this game, I am the real robot.
So it looks like, all right, Cross, all right, I see you, baby. Okay, Zero May Cry 8.
Yeah. Definitely sending a message to everybody. If I hit you, I will not miss. Look at this. I like this. Goes back. Usually a lot of Zeros, you know, they can't wait to engage. And then, you know they have the advantage of Dante assist. Wow.
You know what? Captain America player's name is actually very fitting.
Yeah, to what?
To fight Zero May Cry. You know what I mean? Because it might be game over. It just might be.
When his name advanced in the bracket and, Cross was on the other side, mighty appropriate, perhaps.
Game over.
Let's see if he can prove us wrong, though. Ooh, he delayed. Oh, my gosh. He delayed the lightning at first, but he gets caught anyway by the mix-up. Look at this.
And that mix-up looks a lot worse if there was together in play, so.
Oh, my gosh. He's yet to miss, folks.
Cross is definitely very efficient with his kills, indeed. Hasn't dropped one yet.
Yeah, the Japanese came to play. I can tell you that. Look at that! Intentionally goes away from the corner to avoid any X-Factor shenanigans. Wow!
Smart, yeah. Like you said, shows the mark of a player, man, of a good player.
Yeah. Nice! Oh my goodness, he's ready. Cross is ready, folks. I can tell you that he came to play. Oh my gosh. The only damage that he's been dealt is perhaps chip damage at best. Wow.
Very strong. How, yeah, they say it out there? They go very strong. For some reason, there's a K at the end of the word strong.
And Cross is definitely not saying, okay, USA. He says, no.
No way, USA. That's what he's saying. No way, USA.
He's come to take what America has, and that's Marvel. Let's see. Yeah, look at this. Just maintaining his space, saying, I'm not going to take a chance unless I have to. I have this buster. Would you like me to introduce you to it?
Uh-oh.
Wow, this is going to be interesting.
Oh, I like that. Yo, his assist positioning is pretty good. And he's based.
So good.
Because certain players, they'll see a team like game over, then they'll just go nuts. Oh, this is nothing. I've dealt with worse. But then they'll get hit with something, you know?
Yes.
So Cross showing that respect.
Yeah. And I guarantee you, the fact that he is playing this way, he's going to play this way against low-tier teams, mid-tier teams, and even top-tier teams. He is basically saying, I am in control of the pace of the game.
Very much so.
Look at this. That's the first time he missed the combo, and he doesn't want to take a chance. Stays away. Look at this movement.
Proper placement of this jam session.
Yes.
That is a perfect way to set up a scramble, too, indeed. Mm.
Oh, advances up forward, calls assist, and then up back.
Did you see that? Mm. Did the camera shot cancel out the jam session? Like, you heard it still.
I gotta
check that out. Mm.
Let us know what you think, folks, if that's what happened.
Yeah, for sure. Hashtag Eagle2015.
Look at this. Just dwindling down his life. Ah. Finally finds the hit.
Okay.
Ah. Wanted to keep him in blocks then while he advanced with the jam session assist.
You know, man, I've seen better days for this character.
Yes, we have.
Do
definitely.
You feel bad that he can't do nothing about this?
Yes. Unfortunately, what was once uncontested steel became a plastic robot.
Look at this. Oh my God. Oh my Lord. Get cheese to death. So many dairy products, man.
Cheese, wow!
Get cheese.
I can tell you something. If Cross had more matches, I would want him to. I would want to see him keep playing. I don't want him to get off.
Yeah. Well, so what's going on? Where are we here?
Woo!
I'm chilling. Okay, for sure. Do a little some commercials here.
Paying some bills.
Some ads.
Wow! I'm still amazed by Cross. In the meantime.
Yes, and of course, show that love to Gaming Generations. They actually have their booth out here selling fabulous products, from shirts, from tanks, to jerseys, from hoods, to glassware, from toys.
Everything.
Everything. Literally statues. They got the big Evil Ryu statues, the Doom. Yeah. Everything. Everything that you want in terms of high-quality entertainment and products, you go check that out over there at the Gaming Generations. And check that out online for evo.gaminggenerations.com.
Absolutely. More like, what don't they sell?
Yeah. So you can see all these happy people.
Yes. Is that Jabali on the left?
Yeah, it looked like he laid with good.
Wow. He did a head tilt. Good for him. That's the first time I've seen him.
Rick is the happiest person there. For sure. All the way to the right. Z is like, whatever.
Yeah.
Guy in the back is like, he's cool. And, of course, check out all of Columba's products that are available now. But please be on the lookout for the new products coming very soon. I'm actually a big fan of Columba. I actually got the Columba bag.
Yeah. Okay.
So that holds my weapon, my secret weapon known as the stick, the arcade stick. So. Definitely keep a lookout on that. Check that out, Columba.com. I'm pretty sure that is the website.
Okay. Yes, nice, simple, efficient. They're letting you know we have something for you guys. Look out for it. We got Gamefly. Sign up and rent today. Proud sponsor of Evolution 2015. Yeah. And it ranges everything. Look, you can rent an Ultra, Marvel vs. Capcom 3, Mortal Kombat, whatever you want. And if you do it now, Evo fans get a 2-disc plan free for the first month.
So I would definitely recommend the Xbox 360 version of Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3.
Yes.
And get some Mortal Kombat in. That would be my two. That would be my two. This plan right there. That'll set it off for me. But yeah, go check that out at gamefly.com/evo2015 to redeem.
Al. And now we get to see the match. Now you get to see Yoshi do some shooting. Let's see what
he has. MCGC Yoshi 13 taking on Quasidomo. I will have to say Quasidomo has the cheaper team, but GC Yoshi has the most violent team.
He has a tech. He has a tech for his team.
Yes, I want to see the Chris Redfield prosper.
Explosions, machine guns, you name it, folks. He's coming with everything.
So I want to see, man. I want to see. My favorite that he pulls out the inventory is the shotgun.
Really?
And Hell on Earth. Hell on Earth is the canisters that blow up. There's fire everywhere.
Shotgun because maybe. Just a question. Does it in some way remind you of Cable?
No, it's just disrespectful. It's a white man with a shotgun. And it's Chris, and it's Chris Redfield.
Yeah.
Anybody that's a Resident Evil fan that's relevant to playing Resident Evil nowadays can appreciate Chris Redfield.
Yeah.
I definitely do.
Marquee name for that, too. Chris Redfield.
I remember, I would be not really shocked, but I don't know if there's a real person out there with the name Chris Redfield.
There has to be, but they probably don't know about, this Chris Redfield.
Well, Quasi-Domo's going to find out.
Let's see.
That is if you don't play his game. But we're going to see that. The Trish, there we go. The Trish, Dr. Doom. Okay, so he subs out Super Scroll for Dr. Doom. Okay.
Oh, my gosh. So scary to see X-23, the anchor position. Oh,
that is always the wild card. X-23. Every time I do see X-23, I actually do kind of panic. Like,
yes.
Oh, my God.
Yes. A little chill comes over me when I see my opponent, X-23, as the anchor. Fact of the matter is, if she has 3 meters and she has an incoming, you're dead.
It's a wrap. For sure, it's a wrap. Guaranteed.
Mm-hmm. And it'll be interesting to see how Yoshi deals with this because Trish has so good air mobility. Oh, and while Chris needs to stay grounded, gets caught.
Yeah, you're right. That's one of the weaknesses of Chris Redfield. You can actually avoid a lot of the stuff that's going in the air. Trish definitely has all the tools in the book.
Yeah. And yeah, people in general, the general population is just getting better and better because everybody knows the infinites now. And of course, I say that as he drops it.
I'm telling you, you're the curse, dude. That's not me.
I mean,
I'm telling you. Oh, the cross of standing fist. I'm loving the setup. Oh, we're going to get a taste
of it. Wow. K-Brad looking on the side, loving this. This is his girl. Whoa, okay, no follow-up, but that's fine. Gives Yoshi one more chance.
Nice.
Wow, get over here.
Yes, I like that. Oh, he got ops.
Wow. Yeah, he's going to get a chance to get started with this. Oh, my gosh.
What we got here. He might just do drone super.
Nice.
Into the bubble. Yes. This is going to kill. Add the little extra rocket punch with the extra mileage there on the combo.
Reminiscence of the DHC glitch we used to have. I like that.
Oh, yeah.
Finds the grab. Perfect. Oh, no. You were supposed. Where's the M?
Yeah, like you don't like the boot, man.
Yeah. Oh, and dang. Decisions like this, or accidents like this, rather, just shift the. Again. Come here. Get over here.
Should have done it.
Yeah, they shipped up momentum so much. Now he's lost the X Factor. Yoshi still has it available.
Okay. He should just have a little pressure with the drones. Not too much.
Be careful with these. Yo, what side was that on that he blocked it? And nice hit come from here. He's going to bring him all the way down.
Oops.
Yeah, I was just about to say, I know that every time he hits a hook, there's a happy yipes out there somewhere.
Yeah, man. This is violent. Oops.
Oh, wanted to chip him, but nice push by Quasi-Domo. He has to get out.
Okay, nope. Drones finish off the job. This is definitely still scary.
Yeah, if he gets a hit on Spencer, he will kill, and he does. He has the dirt nap available. Okay, but he's not going to use it yet.
Yeah, not yet. I don't think he can kill.
Yeah, and plus, he probably knew that he was going to force fill out.
Oh, he can't get a combo. That's right. It's only X Factor. He can't get a combo. From my knowledge, anyway.
Wow, other side. He gave him the boot.
Bro, ash. See Yoshi first blood. That was an excellent match. Look, 18 seconds on the clock, which means they had a lot of fun. Oh, yeah. Oh, you saw that? Nothing.
What?
I thought I was gonna get something.
Ah, I see. Meanwhile, Yoshi gets a chance to get started with Chris Redfield. This is what you came to see, Yipes.
Look at this. Sorry, I was distracted.
For a brief moment.
For a brief
no
moment.
Problem.
No problem. Cinematic super. Oh. All right, let me get drones.
What type of incoming do we have? Oh, we are going to get shop started.
Oh, hell on earth.
I see. Doesn't want to deal with this girl. I'm telling you, this girl is a big problem.
Oh, yeah. Let's go. Pop it.
I like that.
Stay right into hell. Just stand into it.
Yeah.
Stand in it, I should say.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, yeah, pick him up. Oh, missed the combo. The home combo.
Yeah. Yoshi's team operates very efficiently when he gets a chance to get started. So, yeah, he will put the bombs on the ground, call the drones, and he starts sniping her. Otherwise, it gives Kosei Domo a free chance to get in. Yeah, see, he needs a chance to, you know, set up the bombs.
Yeah, this looks pretty annoying. Flex 20.
Uh-oh. Finally found the hit. What are we going to do with
He's
this? Okay.
Now it's about to get filthy.
Spencer is dead, folks.
Calling it now. It's guaranteed.
Yeah,
it's guaranteed.
There she goes. She's about to take a nap. Let's go. Look at this. This game is fair.
All right, this situation here was very fair.
Yeah. Oh, but he drops the combo.
I can tell you a lot of reasons why that was fair.
Tell me. Just one.
Let's see. You know what? I can't find one right now. I was just talking on my buttocks. Okay.
My gosh. Again, one missed input, one decision that you make can have a change in everything. He had the game. Spencer was dead. Oh. You know what? This isn't too terrible. If he can somehow kill Spencer, which he does, he is one hit away from victory. But then again, so is Yoshi. So let's see what happens here.
I swear to you, he's going to hit him with a roll. Oh, my God. Don't get it. He can afford to. He has X-Men.
Yes.
He can definitely afford to.
Take two. Again, very dangerous situation for both of them, though. The next hit wins.
Busting out that launcher. I wanted a hit so bad. I'm sorry. I'm a little biased. I want to see a hit.
You might. Oh my God. Oh my gosh. A little bit of nerves right there from Yoshi. But then again, from Quasidomo too. That was a game.
Oh my God. Just one slither. Just one beam, actually. Oh.
I think that might have been a good read. But it's not over yet. It's not over yet, especially with this. Oh, from the heavens comes all the way down. And Yoshi looks up at the sky and says, why me?
That's fun. Okay, back to it. Fresh health bars.
Oh my gosh, here we go. Game two. That could that was it.
That's my gun. That's my gun. Let me get some more.
It's respectful, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
The man with a shotgun. Spread him.
Spread him.
Spread him.
Oh, gosh.
We need some more hell on earth on the ground. There it is. Smoked. You hear that in the
game lets you know, yeah. Not after we get to hear that. Whoa. Yo, is that the same sound that you get in, you know, like in the Resident Evil series?
Bah! I think so. Then you hear the following sound of it.
Okay, yeah. Very wise here, player by Kosei Domo. Wants to stay away from the ground. Gets hit immediately on the ground.
Swords. Oh!
That move always reminds me of Mr. Scorpio.
Whoa! Damn!
Wow. I like this. Snaps in the problem. But then remember, if she gets the hit or she gets going, it could be bad.
I just woke me up. GCO, she woke me up. Too high. I just like that character. Too much.
Suck it. On top of that. Look at that.
Who does that? How you start an attack with a foot and then pull out a knife? That's your chain? Godlike style.
Wow. He guessed what he was looking for. Oh, just to make sure you are about to get hit with this gun, girl.
It's for my Resident Evil 5 fans out there. Y'all remember this weapon?
Which way? Do you know? Oh, we don't get it. That could be a problem.
We got hell on earth. Good awareness.
Wow,
man.
But he finds a way. Nice. Back to the same side. Shades of Paradigm.
That is a pretty efficient mix-up.
Yeah. By the time he gets down there and presses the M, most people won't be holding back at that point. Okay, but Yoshi gets out, and we have almost the same situation as we did last time. Next hit wins. Will we have a repeat of the foot dive?
I don't know. I have faith in a round.
There we go. Whoa! Third time is the charm.
I told you I have faith in that, man. What I say?
Yeah, no, and he definitely can. It's a fail save. If anything should happen, he can cast it to X Factor.
Damn, he really matched us. You know what? It's all about heart at that point.
Right.
When you do it, a little bit of troll factor, but it's all about heart.
What is it in your. What do you feel? What is inside you? Well, no, not that one.
Here we go. Let me get some more. Oh! Oh my God.
Wow, pot!
Oh my
Whoa,
God!
She got hit though. She is struggling out there.
Oh my god, you're getting shot.
Yeah, Trish is in the trenches right now. Fire in the hole. And as much as she wants to stay way up in the air, somehow when she gets down, there is a lot of gunpowder down there.
You know what makes me happy? If he ends the match. Oh, wow. He's
interesting.
I didn't get that.
Was that an alpha counter and he messed up so he tagged back in? Maybe.
Nah, he ain't alpha counter. He might have. Maybe.
You know, Quasi Domo, he's losing this fight. He needs to do something quick.
There we go. We need more of that, actually. Some voltage.
Wow, this song is so sad. I just realized that.
I don't know what it is with the whistles, man, but I guess the song is trying to holler at Trish.
I see. Ooh, nice block there.
The cabeza, son. Colum Jones has blessed the dome, dog.
Yeah, you're just going to stay away, only attack with drones. Oh, but it's... Oh, yo, he is not shy about those foot dives. You remember last game? Or the game before that?
Okay. Uh-oh. Scheming. He got 3 meters on the... Oh!
This time he was ready. You're going to put dive into the drones, he said.
Good snap. We need that.
Oh. You don't want to miss against this girl. Oh, he let it rock. I don't know about this. Both Spencer and Chris are dead. They would have been dead.
Would have been.
Oh! Wow. Perfect positioning. And again, should you make a mistake here at Evolution, you will get punished for it. Such an unforgiving game.
Son of drunks.
Yeah, this is bad. On top of this, folks, this is one of those situations where, like, if the player makes that type of mistake, they're just not mentally there anymore. They're thinking about their mistake.
Yeah.
Right now, Quasi Domo was like, this game was mine. I should have taken this.
That was good stuff. GC Yoshi. Player one advances.
Don't say I didn't warn you.
Abigan. Wow. Please come to your Guilty Gear pool.
That was good stuff. Good show there by both players.
There, Josh. Please return to Guilty
Gear. And the next match we have for you.
Oh, we have Stone Cold Kenneth Bradley representing Evil Geniuses taking on Jason Lim, BZ. I think that's a Z. Yes, that is BZ.
Should Stone Cold be watching this? I'm pretty sure
BZ is about to get busy.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure Stone Cold would say something on the lines of, get on out there and kick some ass, son.
You're like, I tell you. Nah, I can't do Stone Cold. That is a unique voice, man. I can't do it. But look at peep the ponytail game on K-Brad though.
I would pay some serious money to see a Stone Cold Stunner from K-Brad right before the match, or after the match.
Nah, you know what? We're not in a professional setting anymore to do that. So I would think that would be the worst idea. I think you can actually crack a neck.
I would pay serious money for this.
But Pete. Oh, yeah, they did fight in the supermarket. That's right. That is true. I think that was what, Booker T?
Yeah.
That was Booker T.
Randomly, I know the name of the supermarket, fun fact, was the Green Frog Supermarket. That has no relevance to anything we're saying, but I just wanted to get that out there.
Wrestling fans, you already know. But this is Kenneth Storm, Stone Cold Kenneth Storm Bradley, a.k.a. EGK Brad.
Yes.
Very efficient nowadays as a Marvel player. Best known for his great performances in Street Fighter.
Absolutely. You know, but lately, he's been quite the Marvel player. So.
Yep. Got himself into the top eight position. That's CEO, which gave him the opportunity to have that godlike entrance.
Yes.
I must say. I'm jealous. He killed mine. I'm second now.
Yeah.
It's all right, though. It was worth it. That's the whole point of that. You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
You got a ring. You got to really show out and show your personality. So
yeah,
I'm glad that he actually delivered. I think that's a CEO.
It definitely destroyed the internet for a good, I don't know, 2 weeks.
Yeah, man, you got Stone Cold off the seat, drank a beer.
Yep.
So that's what's up.
Watching it and saying,
that's a great deal right there.
In the meantime, we got BZ taking on EGK Brad. Hey, excuse me, can you add a 316 next to K Brad's name, please?
Yeah, it's appropriate.
It's official, yes. Just get K Brad, EGK Brad 316. There we go.
Yeah, I like that.
That's right. Let's put some flair in there. Okay, let's see BZ right now. Magnum Virgil. Okay.
Yeah, you know what? I am seeing more and more of Magnum Virgil lately.
It's an official team. It's a staple Magneto team.
Yes,
if you want to play Magneto, you're going to have to think about this team down the line. You know what I want to see more, though, that I haven't seen? I want to see more Magneto Frank West.
That is so cheap. You said Frank West?
Magneto Frank West, yes.
Hmm.
You have to see that.
You definitely get mixed up potential.
Yep. Okay, here we go.
All right, he decided to pop the X Factor.
K-Brat, perfect links Bradley.
Yeah. But there's one thing that K-Brat has in this game is speed. Look at those. He doesn't miss them.
No heavies?
Oh, he meant to sword up and it all worked out. Oh, this
K-Brat actually tried to get greedy and throw him. What a gamble.
Oh, okay, gets out of that situation. K-Brat's gonna get started.
Woo!
Boy,
movement is clean.
He shouldn't give, yeah, I was gonna say he shouldn't give Dr. Doom a chance to get a hit, and he doesn't.
Wow. Motivated, man. K-Brad is definitely a motivated individual. That was so mean.
Yeah. And which way? I mean, at that point, you definitely just pick a direction and pray that you're right.
That was mad meaty. That's the wave right now with Virgil that I've been seeing a lot actually here out on the West Coast. They do a lot of meaty harvest setups. That way, you know, like you make them block the harvest.
Right.
You kind of have a better chance. You really have a straight up 50-50 when you take a meaty. So it's pretty good.
Yeah, you have to pick a direction. And just wanted to point out that during that last snap, BZ adjusted. He adjusted to the incoming, and now he is facing Virgil. Let's see. Oh.
The jam session. K-Brad might just be my favorite Marvel player right now, besides Zach Bennett when he was playing.
I see.
I'm definitely liking how K-Brad has grown, stuck to his team since day one.
Yes.
Kind of jealous about that. Feel like I should have done that, but it's all right.
Learn neutral. Learn way better neutral than before. He used to be much, much more rushdown based. Came to Cali, learned some really good defense, and now he's employing a little bit of both when appropriate. I like it.
I'm liking this presence by EG K-Brad.
Yeah.
But BZ got some good blocks, though. But he got opened up there, so I guess I cursed.
Yeah, see, it's not just me. It's just me most of the time.
Most of the time. All right, I'll take that.
Keeping it real. Ooh. Oh. Oh, yeah, both of them were confused as to what side they were on. It worked out for K-Brad. Wow, how are you supposed to train for that? How are you supposed to adjust?
Sesame Street assist, man. Peekaboo, dog.
I think that assist is, I don't know, I think it's so underrated. So good. Yeah, look at that.
See, you know what it is? With the hellfire of the Dr. Doom's hidden missiles and all those other assists that'll go upward, a lot of people ain't confident. You know what? Since we don't see enough Trish.
Yes.
That's what it is. That's what it is, ultimately.
But we do from time to time see Doom coming back like this. Oh, my gosh. He is one hit away. Oh, my gosh. What's the mix-up? Oh, he tried the same side, but K-Brad saw it. Nice. I like that. That was pretty much a read right there. Wow.
With confidence.
Yes. It could have gone all bad. The timing could have been different. It could have been wrong. He could have eaten a foot dive. But no, it worked out.
His spacing was perfect. The commitment was perfect. Everything was perfect at that point.
Yeah. It was a good read. It was an educated read, actually. And yes, as I said, look at this. Yeah, that move is just so good. It protects you. It establishes defense. It, you know, you can stall with it.
Yeah, the triangle offense from Magneto does get shut down for sure with that.
Yeah, you know, you can hide underneath it, behind it, add mix-up potential.
Definitely a good assist, man. Been knowing it was a good assist since the Jago days. Shout out to Jago.
Yeah.
So, yeah. We know how efficient it is. Like I said, we don't see enough Trishes to really see it. BZ, I would like to see more.
Yeah. Yeah, no, K-Brad has definitely grown into a player that likes to frustrate his opponents. And you can tell. You can definitely tell BZ's frustrated right here.
Yeah, man. He has the proper teams to deal with this, though. He has to just call missiles and meter halfway in the screen, you know, that way she won't flink away so much.
Yeah, we used to call that in Marvel 2, the box. You have to keep her at a distance where, you know, he has to be aware of Magneto's normals, but he hasn't. He has pretty much like K-Brad, just get away with whatever he wanted in the air.
Sex.
Oh my gosh, here we go. Wants to kill, okay.
Oh, good block. Wow. Delayed blocks everything, but they didn't block that, though. I would just let him die. Dr. Doom at this point?
Yeah.
Oh, man. He didn't realize he didn't have 2 meters. Again with the cross-up. Wow. Yeah, he needs a TAC.
And I don't agree.
I think a miscalculation there by K-Brad giving him one more chance. This is the one character you don't want to give one more chance, but it doesn't matter. K-Brad adjusts, and great performance. I like it.
And 3-0, nice, quick, and easy with that lame team.
Yes. When I mean lame, I just say Trish. I'm a very, very, very big fan of Dante and Virgil.
Okay. But the big ups, though. Well, hello there. I see you.
Yes.
See me? I see you.
Absolutely. What are you doing with this weekend? Evolution? We are too.
Evolution, man. Let me see. We got a lot of evolution. I'm about to go to Johnny Rockets when I tag out. That's what I think I'm about to do.
Johnny Rockets?
Johnny Rockets.
That nice. Medium rare.
I'm a well done kind of guy.
Oh,
but just for you,
interesting.
Mm-hmm. I'll do medium.
Thank you.
I'll do medium. Apparently, if you're doing it the wrong way, if you do it well done. I did not know that.
Yeah. Well, is it that you don't like, you know, that's me? You think that, like, it has too much pink? I don't think you could ever go wrong with pink.
I don't know. It's a mental thing.
I think more than anything.
So right now, stepping up to the plate, it is Broken Tears Angelic versus Manic.
Ooh, this would be interesting. Okay, so obviously, Angelic, an established player, has done really well here in the past, but Manic is definitely an up-and-comer from SoCal who's been very hungry and has been doing really well lately. So
really? What team does he play?
He plays Morrigan. I want to say Morrigan Doom Strider, if I'm not mistaken. It's definitely Morrigan Strider. I don't know if it's Doom or Virgil. But he's been doing quite well in the tournaments in SoCal. So let's see what he has for us right here.
Okay.
And look at that. Of course he's going to have a Shuma shirt. I respect that, Angelic.
He likes the one ojo grande.
One eye.
One-eye bandit. Weird body for combos. Increases his chances of escaping some mix-ups and combos. But no, Angelic, like you said in the past, done really well. 2013 was his real time to shine.
Mm.
He got top 8. Third place, actually. He was actually close.
Yeah.
So,
and you know what's interesting? And you've heard this from a couple of players in the past. What happens when these players do really well? It's that he told me. You know what I did? I actually stopped caring. Not completely, not recklessly, but you know that pressure, that sense of I have to do well. This evolution, I can't make a mistake. He said he just let it go. You know, same thing with Noel Brown when he did really well. He said that he played his game, didn't let the nerves get to him, and played as if he was at home. And it often works out really well.
Yeah, that pressure of always performing well is not fun, man.
Yeah, not healthy.
It's definitely not healthy. Yeah, that's a better way to put it.
Right.
Because it puts you in a zone where it actually throws you off your element and you actually play a different way. So.
And you see it. And you see it in the reactions, the emotions of some people. You know, that they're extremely stressed. They make a mistake and they just maybe jump off their chair or something, you know.
So I give a lot of credit to guys like Champ, Just, Chris G.
Yeah.
Well, they're consistently in there. They're going to win or actually just consistent, you know?
Absolutely.
So it's a good thing, a good trait to have.
So this show will be quite interesting, folks. Oh, there we go. It is Morrigan, Virgil Strider. Starts out with an uppercut. Okay, to get away.
Oh, my God. Ducks it completely.
That's a hit. I think he's going to get hit. Yep.
Ooh, okay.
Oh my gosh, yeah, the evolution nerves are right now strong. He's hit him twice.
A little too reckless.
Okay.
Oh, I like that.
Oh my gosh. However, if there is one anchor that can do it, it's Shuma. Let's see
if Manic can fend away the powers of Shuma Gorath.
And it seems like he's going to be able to. Just gets the second meter. Oh, he's going to fall down into the sister. Yep. Wow, Manic showing he's hungry. He's here to play. Angelic needs to make some adjustments right now.
So pretty. But yes, he definitely He definitely does.
I definitely remember some of the things that, you would do to court her, if I might say so.
Yeah. 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 Yes.
Right. Which pretty much should be anything.
Yeah. Okay.
And yeah. Yeah. Okay, let's let me cut it off.
All right. Oh my gosh, the ever patented Helm Breaker.
90% hit ratio. I must say, that is a 90% hit ratio. No, it wasn't really necessary, but just make sure I like it.
Okay. Which way are you going to do it? Oh, the no mix-up, but Angelic blocked it. He needs to hurry up. X-Factor's running out. Yeah, it's going to be enough.
Ooh.
But this time he has no X-Factor on Shuma, so let's see. Yeah, see, he's not going to be able to do much with this, and Angelic gets one more chance.
Should have not wasted his resources like that. Oh,
oh,
who am I to tell him what to do?
Oh, went for a reset. This could be it. This is it. Oh, my God. All of a sudden, Manic is up 2-0. Angelic just out of nowhere finds himself in this bad predicament. He should go to the character select screen. Yep.
You know what's Angelic's biggest weakness is what he does at the beginning of a match.
Mm.
People are trying to catch on that Angelic is really thirsty for the scramble situation.
Yes.
So they'll actually afford to take more risks to like press up at the beginning, get a trade, or maybe a clean hit,
or maybe
like
a bionic arm.
Oh, that.
Kyle P, where are you?
We've seen that, you know. So that is definitely a pretty obvious weakness at the beginning. So let's see what happens.
Well, Marble is definitely cutthroat this year, folks.
Yeah, man, I'm telling you, I'm scared. Well, I'm never scared. I'm confident, but I'm just scared to see what I'm gonna bump into in the pools, you know?
Absolutely. Yes, we're gonna do work. Don't worry.
Yes, we are.
No, nice awareness there by Manic.
That was actually very unsafe, by the way, man. Like that dive kick on the top of the screen.
Yeah, see, Angelic, yeah. No, Angelic definitely wants to go in and get the hit, but he should not do it at the expense of being unsafe like that. Oh my gosh, Angelic. Oh my God, but he drops the combo.
He's doing a quick pickup here.
Oh, wow. Okay, finally finds himself in a dominant position.
Angelic looking back to his rear. Oh.
That is 3-for-3 so far. 4-for-4 so far.
See what I'm saying, man? He's always trying to force a scramble situation. Well, that's going to hit.
Oh. Wait a minute. Oh, no. What is happening here?
You know, that was a good decision. Just so we can have Virgil on
deck.
Oh,
my gosh. He killed Shuma. Nice. I like that. Delayed the entrance a little bit so they could get the mix-up with Strider. Angelic has one more chance. He has to make it count.
He definitely has to make it count right
oh
now.
Oh, my gosh. Ahead. Manic got the hit. This is it, folks. He advances 3-0, sends Angelic to the loser's bracket. Wow.
That was pretty fast, actually.
Yeah.
Very dominant. I would say. Very dominant.
And as you said, it was a product of Angelic trying to go in the beginning. Just got punished for it.
One of his biggest weaknesses, yes, he's always trying to force a scramble, and then the scramble actually bites him. So,
yeah. And folks, this is what we're telling you. Everybody wants to do well at this Evo. So there is no match that's, you know, for free.
I actually forgot he was here. Is he even available?
I don't know who that is, but that is a godlike name.
Punisher?
The other one.
Oh, Frank Dukes. Oh,
mm.
I think this is Frank Dukes. Frank Dukes?
Ooh! He got 20 years or so young.
When's Marvel? It's now.
You.
It's now,
thank
bro.
Thank you. But I got 20 years young, came back from the Kumite, and is not competing electronically. I like this.
Yes, all right. There you go. He did step up. All right. So we got KPP, LVLG, Hitbox, Punisher. Taking on Frank Dukes.
Let's see.
That is a confident name, I must say.
Let's see if Punisher can, in the words of Bolo, say, "You are next." Chung Lee, rather. I like to call him Bolo.
It's Bolo. It's Bolo.
For me, that was his best performance. Only because he was with Bruce Lee, mighty Bruce Lee.
Okay.
Look at this. What is Cloud doing here, Cloud? You know,
that's awkward.
Yeah. You know, you get out of here before I sidekick you
kind of awkward. He was like, I like how your arms feel, but your arms, they feel better. His name's Frank Dukes, but your name's Punisher.
I definitely need. Oh, my God. Okay, Cloud.
All right, let's get back into it. So we got Punisher, New York Zone, taking on, I'm assuming, since Cloud's being so up.
Oh my God, this is priceless.
And jumpy.
This is priceless. The guy sitting next to Frank Deuce, he's like a skinny Jackson. I am not kidding.
Oh, wow.
He looks like the sidekick. Yes, he does. He looks like exactly like the sidekick.
Frankie.
Frankie.
but don't you get too cocky now.
All right, Frankie.
You might have to play me next.
You look like a guy.
He definitely looks like him. Look at this. You cannot write this up, folks. This is lie. This is evolution.
Way to go, Frankie.
His first fight at Evil Keeps... His first fight at Evil, he broke the effing world record.
That can't be.
That's what I'm telling you. You cannot write this up. Folks, sometimes in life we get these presents. We get these things that just brings us that type of joy. We are witnessing one right now.
What is that?
And he can definitely hear us. I guarantee you, folks, that he can definitely hear us. He doesn't mind us. He says, whatever.
He'd be like, anytime, any place, anywhere. Yeah, I forgot what he said.
I'll be there. I will be there.
Oh, I will be there. Yeah, yeah.
All he needs is a beer can.
I love you.
Okay, Punisher, back in action right now.
Back to reality.
Oh, I would have done it.
Who we got? Oh, we got something. Okay. We got Dante Dormammu version. Interesting.
Yeah, actually he's doing great work with Hawkeye. Look at this. Doing that keep away game, shooting him, sniping him.
I definitely think Punisher has the best Hawkeye right now. In the business right now.
Yeah, I would have to agree.
Wow, got a trade off of that. Wow, sucks for Frankie.
I want to see some Dormammu, though. I feel like we haven't seen some Dormammu this whole tournament, or at least the time I've been here.
No, you're right. We haven't. Yeah. We actually haven't. No, I saw it earlier from Hyrule, but that's about it. That was the last time I've seen it.
I like that decision. So good. Oh, but he gets flipped anyway.
Damn, right there. Punisher put himself in danger. Could have just backed off and chucked arrows. I don't agree. Could have just gonna burned it off.
The ball? Oh, okay. Just wants to kill him. Oh, but he missed the target. No.
I thought that flame was active.
Allow him.
Oh, I like that setup. Oh, should have got a little closer.
Oh. Yeah, he didn't expect that prediction to happen. Okay, yeah. No, you know what? This is excellent keep away. Look at this. Oh my gosh, buddy. God, a happy birthday. MODOK is going to go. He would have gone down. I like him playing the air more. Yeah.
That is the perfect place to be. Especially against this guy, El Diablo.
Uh-huh. Seguramente.
Seguramente. Oh, he's dead.
Yeah, we know. Oh, he's
a little nervous.
Well, yeah. Evolution, folks. And he gets a sword in the face for his troubles. Oh, this little guy can be quite the problem, let me tell you.
I have a bad experience with this character, I must say.
I am right there with you.
Wow. And the gun is bigger than him. So I don't know where he's pulling that from.
It's true. Wow.
The gun is bigger than him, but he's pulling it out of his back pocket. Rocket Raccoon. Never shares his tech. All right, Punisher takes game number one. Okay. I would like to see more of an aggressive approach here by Frank Dukes.
Ah, yeah. Wow, he is suffering with that poison coursing through those veins.
You know what would have been funny chilling next to Frank Dukes? Not Jackson. Who's the Asian trainer?
Not
the trainer, but the guy that was just hyping him up.
Yeah, the travel guide.
Yeah, damn, what's it?
He'd be like, all right, Frankie!
Yeah.
He's one of those characters that you only hear his name once in the movie, just so that he could be introduced, and then you never knew who he was anyway. You have a chance to make history, Frank. Forget about the good.
Yeah. Forget about the good. No, it's funny. Yo, the Punisher holds record. Oh, nice confirmed it.
You know the only thing also that we do need is the Asian gentleman on the sideline making investments, making them, asking Frank
with the suit.
Yeah. How do you feel today, Dukes? Good. Dukes, my man.
Dukes, my man.
And not. It would be Nemo.
Oh, wow.
But Dukes doesn't feel good right now, folks. Let me tell you, he is getting all kinds of shot at. Oh, my God.
Oh, la potilla.
You know what's happening right now? Frank Dukes is suffering from that powder that, you know.
Oh, with the wide eyes?
Yeah, that he shot him at with. But let's see if he can wake up.
I don't know, dude.
I think he might have woken up. Yup. He remembers his training.
Right now.
Oh, he tried to snipe him. And he buys a little bit of time. Okay, at the same time, he puts a trap on the ground.
Okay.
Yes, I was just about to say, yes. Rocket Raccoon typically does well against Dormammu, and you are seeing why. Great mobility, or at least evasiveness.
You know what? This is actually a rare match. I really get to see this. Dormammu versus the Shorty.
Yep.
Wow, Jansen Shinde connect. Sucks for Frank Dukes.
This one's for the rest.
Anytime, any place, anywhere, wherever you need me, I'll be there.
Oh, here, he's trying to be there, but not working out so well.
See, at least that's probably what he's saying. Right now. Yo, you should give that man a bandana. Harley Davidson bandana, it's a wrap.
Yeah, with a little blood stain on the side. Okay. Yeah, Frank Dukes has definitely got to do something different. He's been getting sniped every single game. So he has to find the gap.
This is actually a good approach, though. He started Virgil this time. This is pretty good. There we go. He's going to have to predict the push. Let me tell you one thing about Hawkeyes, right? They will always push back no matter what because they want to create that space.
Right.
So Frank Dukes can definitely identify that actually to punish with like a stinger, run up, go low. He has options, but he's not really taking advantage of it. But he's killing Hawkeye right now, so that is definitely a plus. Burn the Thunder.
Wow. Oh, wow. I like that. Flew right over the fire. He knew when it becomes inactive despite the animation. And you get rewarded for that type of knowledge. Look at this.
Punisher almost close to closing it out. Right here, 3-0. You know what? I just want one game. Just one game.
Yeah. Show some resistance. As you said, Curly. Do not let this happen like this.
Can't, man. Oh. Level 3.
Wow. Burrows to the other side and forces the X Factor. He's gonna force his own X Factor. Yep. Yo, the trap got Dante when he came in to assist him.
Virgil. Yo, no, because this is what he said. He said, boing. Ah!
The pain.
Oh, man.
Oh, my gosh. It's a pretty even matchup, though.
Oh, nice. Pin them down there for some extra chips. He actually has the lead right now. He can actually just chill out.
My body's ready. My heart's on fire. Let's see.
Oh! Oh, but that would be cool.
Kumite.
Come on, Frankie.
We need one game from you, Frank. That's all we need. All
right, way to go, Frankie. Yo, come on, man. Oh, way to go, Frankie. And way to go.
And the Asian guy.
Well done.
Oh, my God.
All right. Way to go, Frankie.
I love this line from Dormammu. Oh my gosh.
You're punishing. Straight looking Minikin in the face.
Right. Come on. If Frank Dukes gets this game, that's when he remembers his training. When he had the bandana on so he couldn't see.
You know what? Frank Dukes would be a Virgil player though, for sure.
Mm.
Maybe just to be part of his martial arts.
He wouldn't be a Zero player though. I don't think it would be Devil May Cry.
Yeah.
He gives his opponent a chance to play though.
No.
Remember, he does. Remember when he was placing the Muay Thai guy?
Dude, he was one touch killing everybody. What are you talking about?
No, not Frank Dukes.
I think the only guy he was playing the food with was the
Remember the Muay Thai guy that he fought?
The sumo guy's playing.
Yeah.
That's what the Muay Thai guy. Yeah.
Oh damn.
Ouch! All right, Frankie.
Oh my gosh, we are probably gonna get the last game, folks. Oh my god.
Dude,
where's the girl?
That's too funny. Hey, you wanna play some games? Remember you was playing?
Oh yeah.
The karate champ,
yes,
I think it was.
Yes, yes.
Aren't you a little too young for full contact? Aren't you a little too old to be playing fighting games?
You're like Frank Dukes. But that's when they started introducing yes, that was yes. Classic. All right, Punisher's still in there. Damn, I'm here trapped in memory lane. I was about to go to freaking the kickboxer.
Yeah, yeah.
Now I'm getting mad memories of a random Van Damme flicks.
Mm-hmm.
Tamiya's big old windmill kicks and crotch shots.
Yeah, Tamiya's when Tong Po was kicking the pillar. Oh, holy crap. Nonetheless, yeah, we have ourselves an honest match. No X Factor. Oh, wow. The
hitbox is that big? I didn't even know that.
Yeah, both of them want to stay away. They want to take as little risk as possible. They're both nervous. This could be it for Frank Dukes.
Oh my God! Stop taking a risk with that S, my friend.
See that? Come on, Frankie!
Yeah. Oh, he got caught! Oh my gosh! I think he needs one more hit though. It's not over.
Yeah, he. Oh, he does have the meter.
Okay, here we go.
Oh, teleport to get out the corner a little bit.
Oh, he's trying to mix him up by burrowing, but nice block there from Frank Dukes.
Damn, he is running away.
Frank, you're about to lose a Kumite. You cannot do this. Oh, he went for it and got caught.
Any place.
Oh, here we go.
Anytime. Anywhere. If you need me, I'll be there.
Damn, Frankie. Couldn't get the Harley Davidson bandana back, dude.
Yeah.
But that was a great show by both players. They was definitely having some fun.
Absolutely.
They was definitely having some fun. Okay. So up next is T.A. Fruzzi. Oh, T.A. Tears Fruzzi. Everybody knows Fruzzi. He was actually got top 8 in 2012.
Yes.
2012, for sure.
Came all the way from La Ciudad de Mexico and definitely made
your hometown, for sure. Yeah, taking absolutely. On Solid Abyss. That you better have a very deadly team for you to have that name.
Mm-hmm.
Solid Abyss.
And Black Mama shirt? No.
And they look like it for a second, yeah.
Yeah. And, you know, we can expect Fruzzi to be playing his patented MODOK. I don't think he ever left that machine.
I think he added Dr. Doom to the team. I think it's Captain America.
MODOK, Dr. Doom?
MODOK, yeah. And then I think he has a variation with Taskmaster from the last time I've seen him play. But this should be interesting. Fight! Hailing all the way from Mexico.
Yes. Yes. One thing that I do want to say about Fruzzi that I never forgot during that Evo is that we had a camera shot of his stick. And in the stick, everybody from back home, everybody, his mom, his uncles, his relatives, all signed it and said the same things like, good luck. We love you, blah, blah, blah. And then afterwards, somebody tried to buy the stick off of him for, I believe, $2,000. He kept the stick.
Oh, boy, this shit has a lot of money. I'm pretty sure he has that stick right now.
Absolutely. Right now? I don't know about right now. He might be saving that in case he gets top 8 again. That stick was made, as you and I know, from the ancient wood. When you sit on the ground, it was that type of stick.
Oh, really? It's enchanted?
Yes.
Like that?
Yes.
Oh, okay. That's what's up.
Yes.
All right, so let's see what Solid Abyss pick. Oh, we got Nova, Frank, West. Oh, okay, yes, I did see him play before. All right. Oh, Tier 3. Okay, so that must be his sponsor. Big up to Tier 3. Yeah, you got it right. Fruzzi. So, yeah, there you go. MODOK, Captain America. That's a great choice.
Mm-hmm.
He was rocking Taskmaster, like I was saying earlier. But I don't think he needs the arrows, not for MODOK. Especially when you have all that stuff that can control the ground. Having something to control the air like hit and misses is a great addition to this team.
Yep. Compliments MODOK so well.
Did he always play Dr. Doom? No, he played Taskmaster.
No,
right?
Yeah. He definitely played Taskmaster.
Okay.
It is a requirement that if you're in Mexico, one of your first team has to have Taskmaster in it. Something along those lines.
There's some La Parka in there. I hear that.
MODOK play though.
Now Solid Abyss right now. I don't know what is he gonna do with Frank West, but he should be finding ways to build meter right now so he can bust out that double team and try to get an opening or try to get some camera shots. Yeah, he needs something right now. Level Frank Whack is whack.
Yeah, you can tell he's a little bit confused about what to do right now. Oh, but he gets the hit. He probably hasn't, you know, he's not experienced with gets slowed up or something.
Go right here, double team. Okay, he might go level 4. He will go level 4. Level 3.
Just enough. It would have been unfortunate for him, and MODOK died before the snapshot, but he didn't. Little help, and he gets it, but he missed the second hit.
Push locked him into the missiles. Nice.
You know what, though? This isn't too terrible, though. You know what? That's one thing that I've been seeing from Dante players a lot more now. The snap will give you a fail safe, and then you can cancel to X Factor and adjust accordingly. Wow, other side.
Ooh, wow, that was so vanilla, that combo. Ooh.
Yeah, and all of a sudden we have ourselves a situation where Fruitsy must be on the defensive. Nice block there. Oh, gets punished for it. Wow.
Should have done an air play, at least a hammer to make it safe. But big mistake there by Solid Bits, and Fruitsy capitalizes. Okay, okay, okay. Taking some time right here. Solid Bits' coach is giving him some advice.
Go for broke.
Oh, here we go, Nova. Oh, good hit.
Oh, that could have been bad. Nice block there by Fruitsy.
Oh, I like Fruitsy's style of play, man. Very cool, calm, collective, very calculative.
Oh, yo, it is an anomaly when I see Nova not have enough time or confirm that grab. There's so many stories behind that grab.
The Nova grab?
Yeah.
There is a lot of stories there. Main story being I meant to grab.
Yes.
That's my favorite story. My favorite children's book. Okay, nice finish there by Fruitsy.
Yeah, Fruitsy taking his time. I like this.
Very nice.
Oh, missed the input right there, but that's okay. Yeah, okay, and this is where Solid Abyss has to remember that last game, he wasn't very active, and it cost him a lot.
And that's all you got is a piece of pie, you touch somebody. This is a great punish. He can actually,
Oh no, oh, that is the absolute worst situation. When you activate X Factor with an idea, and they hit you, and you see your characters die.
Your hypothesis has been canceled.
Yeah. Nope.
Okay. Fruitsy 10-0, 2-0.
Well, yeah, I want to see more of that. I want to see more javelins. Set up shop.
He definitely needs to apply the pressure. I don't know why he's back there.
Yeah, I think he's just scared, you know, or at least hesitant. Oh, no.
This just tends to happen in a tournament, man. The player actually sits there and thinks too much of just not running the...
Oh, that's following him like the blue shell in Mario Kart. Oh, lucky for him, he avoided it.
Oh, that is a level 4.
Oh my gosh. Okay, finally he gets a chance to get started.
Level 5. Excuse me.
Oh wow.
Pardon me, Solid Abyss.
Wow, that was up there. I don't care if you're MODOK, you can fly or you can. I have a saw. Look at this.
Wow, you survived.
You're gonna. No. Oh wow, it didn't matter.
Ooh!
Yeah, everything going very well for a Solid Abyss in this game, and of course he drops it as soon as I say that.
Your curse, not mine. Oh my god, wow, what a trade.
Oh my gosh, it's gonna be up to Dr. Doom. He does have X Factor available though. Wow! That was
Las Rodillas of Justice.
There will be no Latveria today, folks.
Oh my god. That is so much meter. I like the team composition, but I saw the best for sure.
And what a mix-up.
All right.
Okay. Nice answer there by Solid Abyss. Get something going.
Hell yeah, you can put some momentum back in this time.
Yeah. Yeah, and a little more confidence. You can see, yeah. He gets the game and he goes, you know what? I can't just not do anything. I see the game plan. Okay, I see what he's trying to do. He's trying to call shopping cart assist and go in, but he's hesitant to do it because he doesn't know when he's gonna get sniped. Look at this.
That's right.
Yeah. See, he's like, when can I go? When is my turn?
Well, he could throw some random Superman supers out there just to throw them off.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
I do not know if the shield actually negates it or something. That's probably why the Nova ain't doing it. I wouldn't know, but I'm assuming he'll crack through the shield.
Wow, nice jump there from Fruits. He probably had to read that Nova was going to come. Came down with a button and caught him.
Cabeza.
Wow.
Nice. Fruitsy combos.
Yeah.
Classics.
However, last time this is sort of what happened. Nice block there. Every block here is crucial. Oh my gosh.
Yo, it's amazing that MODOK could
do this to you while sitting down
on a chair and chilling.
Like, really, he has everything that he needs in those fingertips and the joystick, right?
Yep. He can fly, he can spit.
Oh, man, I remember the good days when I first seen the release trailer of MODOK.
Yeah.
Wow.
That was going to be your man?
No, I was just excited because I did not expect him to be in a Marvel game at all, ever.
I see.
And that was, when I seen that, it was a great surprise.
Definitely being well represented here by Fruitsy.
Yes, sir.
Okay, let's see if we can get anything going right now. He does. Okay, this is too terrible.
Okay.
He needs to get a hit on Captain America as soon as possible, though. He blocked it.
Oh, no resources.
Yeah.
Whoa! He's gonna. Wow, nice button choice for the back jump.
And Fruitsy, in a convincing win, says, I advance.
That was Scott, like, he downbeat the cross.
Yeah, I don't think that was a push button. I don't think that was one of those situations. I definitely think he just knew how to deal with that situation.
Yeah, the button you always see on a push flag will be roundhouse, crushing roundhouse. Mm-hmm. Oh, look what we got here. A special treat. We got the Starburst King.
Yes.
Ultra Arcade's own. Terry Bogard.
Versus.
Damn, I want to send a song, but he's Pony? Not local battles no more.
Is it Pony?
He is Tempo. No, he's Tempo Chris G.
Oh,
brother.
Wow. We are about to see some soul
fisting. And it's kind of weird, but interesting that they always do end up in the same pool as each other. They ended up at final round. I think. No, they didn't play a CEO. They did play a team tournament, though, really early on. And then now, here we go in the grand stage in the world championships. You got Terry Bogard, a.k.a. Power Wave. Versus yes. Tempo's own Chris E.
Yes. Yes. Fight. And if I may, I would love to see a pink Starburst. As I said earlier, you can't really go wrong with pink.
Damn. So. I want. You know what? I ain't gonna put. Hold on.
Terry, you got Starburst?
No.
I definitely just asked Terry if he had some Starburst. That question was not meant to be a rhetorical one, Terry. Hook us up.
Cloud, excuse me.
I love when we get these presents. You know, like when Abigan gave us, you know.
So chocolate? I'm doing Terry justice right here. Hold on.
What are you? What?
Do what? Okay. There we go. Here, can you give Terry his powers back, please? Mm. Thank you.
Terry, that's how much I love you, baby. I ain't take none of the reds of pink.
Yes.
I see. Oh, okay.
That's how much love I have for Terry.
Oh, so those are the ones he doesn't like.
I don't know if he likes them. I mess with yellow. I mess with yellow Starburst and orange.
Really?
I mess with those. But I know his powers come from the red and pink Starburst.
Ah.
So I had to take the booty one.
I tend to get power with the pink Starburst.
Do you? Okay.
In some ways. Cloud took the yellow one. I'm tight. You know, of all the possibilities, he had to take the one, right? The one you want. For sure. What else would he get?
Come on, man. I mean, at least let me build up to the orange with the yellow.
Folks, all jokes aside, this is a serious match. Both of these guys, very hungry, very much at the pinnacle of Marvel's top gameplay right now. They both want to advance. Terry Bogard, I want to say maybe a little hungrier than Chris Schmidt.
Chris G. And Dr. Schmidt, he's here.
Yes. And here we go, folks. Get ready for some fisting action.
Yep. Oh, yeah. This right here? Oh, yeah. Fight. All right. Ultra Arcade Zone. Terry Bogard starts it off. Chris G is patiently waiting,
gosh,
for his chance to get his fireballs going.
Yeah.
There it is, the opening.
Yeah. Yeah. I would think Chris G wants to be second. Yeah. He's very much a defensively oriented player, and he wants to avoid all danger. He will let Terry Bogard probably go first unless it's a special circumstance.
Yep.
Nonetheless, Terry Bogard right now.
Yeah, I like how Strider sound like he's getting son of a.
Yeah, you know what? It's that Strider assist helping him out. Chris Jean definitely has to be mindful of that assist. You get hit with that assist and you can fall into four or five fireballs.
Yep. Last time these two met, Terry Bogard did win. And convincingly 3-0-2.
Wow.
So, yeah.
Oh my gosh. Okay. That hurts.
Wow, brother on brother action, huh?
Nice. Oh, and interesting. Was that a fireball assist?
Yeah, Morgan, yeah. That's what they use.
Oh, interesting.
Give a little new ground control with Dante. No, it's pretty interesting assist. He has a little setup, cute combos with it too.
Okay.
Very, very, very unorthodox, but I like it. Usually you see players using the meter assist.
Oh, nice! Clip the legs. Down B is an excellent button against Virgil's.
I think, yeah, he's doing it. He's doing it. Because he gets an incoming on Dr. Doom.
Can he get another one?
And okay. And even if he doesn't, Dr. Doom will have to build at least 2 meters to get out of that situation. All right. Wow, and there it is. There it is, that use of the assist. You don't see that too often.
That was like, and it's mad slow too, so you wouldn't expect it in a situation like that.
Right. One of those things that you face at EVO is that you don't know what the little tricks that your opponents may have. It's so difficult to adjust on the fly.
Oh, not enough. Oh, okay. Damn, I keep forgetting she has that super.
Everything she says just sounds right. I don't know. I have no idea what she said, but I would have said yes to it.
Ooh. Oh, the side messed him up.
Alright, Chris G, however, so yep, there it goes. Still has X Factor available. Oh, wow. Get down here, girl. Wow, lucky. Very lucky.
Very lucky. Very ballsy.
Nice block there. Ooh, he's trying to hang on. Chris G with the missed input. Wow, he really tried to punish that? Oh my gosh.
Yeah, he figured he would teleport behind him, but stayed in front.
Oh my god, Chris G trying to. Wow. Yeah, it's very hard to challenge her when she's activated.
I think if Chris G wants to win his match, he's okay. He's good now.
I think Terry's gonna activate too.
This is gonna be a nail biter. I think Terry's gonna bank on the time.
Wow, the shell kick. Chris G somehow comes back. Wow. I think you know what? I do think that the momentum shifted when he decided to try to punish the missed input by Chris G. He should have stayed away and held his ground.
Yeah. But, oh, when he teleported with Strider.
Yes.
Yeah. He definitely put himself in danger.
I think he, in one of those situations, you know what? I just want to end the game right now. I want to go to the next one and can bite you back in the butt.
Terry's still in the game, though. I like, you know what I'm liking about Terry nowadays, man? His confidence has grown to such another level.
Okay. And you know what? Interesting. He went to the character selection screen, but we have to see a Starburst. There we go.
I'm telling you, man. And that's just and that's a blessing for me, though. Yes. Listen, if I was a scumbag, I would have bodied that whole rack of pink and red, man. Let me tell you. Yeah. But just because it's Terry, I'm going to let it slide. Neil, if it was yours, bodied.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. If it was Wisconsin, bodied.
I would have looked at you like, wait, there's some stuff missing here.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I don't know.
He's talking about Starburst. I took all the orange and yellow ones. Just love them.
I see. And Terry Bogard, like, look at that. He gets a natural smile from chewing.
Yeah, man.
It's like that ever collected, you know, like, everything's okay.
Yeah, man. You know what, Casey, he's in a combo saying, man, this red Starburst tastes good.
Okay, so let's see if this Starburst can give him the power that he needs to make the adjustments. Actually, he doesn't need to make that many adjustments. He made some really good decisions the first game. It was just that last decision.
That one decision, yeah. Okay. It's amazing how Terry deals with the Morgan and the hit and miss with just Morgan. Like, no assist, no real backup, like, to fend off. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, Strider's more or less there not to really, like, do any real damage, but to check Chris G. To help him with the neutral.
Oh, nice. Jam session. Helps him out. Ooh.
I don't know, though. Chris G seems to be finding his rhythm. There is very few things that are worse than when Chris G finds his rhythm, let me tell you. Yeah.
Oh, so man, that low.
Gotta take care of this problem.
Definitely gotta respect them, especially when you got the incoming missiles coming in. You gotta respect it.
And this all works beautifully for Chris G because not only does he get an incoming, but he is gonna, you know, dwindle Dante down. There is the hit.
This time push block there by Terry Bogard. He's about to bite him.
What color of Starburst are we gonna eat now to help us?
Man, I think he's still got the red one. He's down 2-0 right now.
Ooh,
though,
so Chris G with a little bit of a body pump.
Yep.
There it is again. Ooh. Oh, not this time he's shaking his hands. Okay. And look at that. Terry Bogard still with a smile on his face. Welcome to the
world of Marvel versus Capcom 3. Don't know why Chris is fanning himself so much. You know, it's crazy the caliber of Chris G and all his achievements and what he's just basically done. He still gets nervous.
Yeah.
Still gets nervous.
I think, you know what, if we're being 100% honest, I think it's that he wants to go back to that one spot that he had once, that he held one time, where pretty much I think for at least the better part of the year, he was just completely uncontested.
Oh, yeah, 2012 going into mid-2015, he was unstoppable, no doubt about it. Yeah.
He still tends to be unstoppable when he wants to.
Right.
But
you know what? People are fighting back now.
Yeah. The biggest pressure behind Chris G right now is, will he take an Evo? Because that's pretty much all he's missing in his cabinets of medals and stuff. Is an Evo achievement. So,
right?
Okay. Well, you know what? Question. Who do you like to win Evo? If it's not you and me, of course.
You know what? I think there are definitely two people that have been standing out for the past couple of months.
And we're talking Champ and who else?
Mr. Justin Marvelous One.
You think that might be the finals? I don't know, man.
I think that will definitely be either losers finals or winners finals or some type of finals.
If I don't make it or you don't make it to the finals,
who do you think is going to get there?
I would love to see in the finals, in the grand scheme of things.
Yes.
Nemo Champ.
Interesting. A nice twist to the storyline right there.
In the grand scheme of things, I want to see it.
And at the conclusion of that matchup?
Brings it. You know I'm going to go for Champ. Lucky from USA. I have to go with Champ.
Well then.
Oh, but Ben, really, it's back to the match. Sorry, folks.
Yes,
Terry
yes.
Bogard commanding lead, and as soon as I said so, I'm sculpt.
And let's not forget something, folks, as we're actually on the talking about the topic. Justin Wong has placed a personal bounty on himself, Chris G, and Filipino Champ.
That's so right. Yeah. So if you eliminate the three guys of Marvel,
anyone or multiple.
So you could potentially make $900.
Yes, but it's not. You cannot just send them to losers. You have to eliminate them.
Yeah. So that kind of sucks. If Terry Bogard does it now, he gets no money. But the guy that eliminates them is
gets a $300.
$300.
Yes. However, Chris G is trying to put this final statement.
Whoa! If that was a read, that was amazing. I agree.
Wow.
I agree. That was good. That was
solid. I don't think that was an accident. I don't think that was meant to be orbs. Oh, Chris G, okay, he himself had a little bit of a plan right there, but oh my god, Terry Bogard blocked the foot dab, and now we have ourselves a match, folks.
You definitely do.
Oh, nice right there, uppercut, avoiding the mix-up. Terry Bogard,
with the trade!
Wow, just enough, I think just enough.
Wow! What a fabulous trade.
Oh, and a taunt right there by Terry Bogard talking about that confidence.
Man,
you were speaking
earlier. Where the crowd came from?
I don't know. They heard.
You're Marvel.
They heard the halls.
Stop. If you or die, fight. Okay. Terry Bogard brings this back. You could call me Susan. No. That's too much.
Okay. 2-1, folks. Chris G, though. Okay.
Nice.
He needed that break. He needed that.
That stride is going to hit.
Yeah, and what this essentially does is gives Terry Bogard the first attempt at the soul pit, but nonetheless.
Ooh, putting himself in danger there. I would like to see more air plays from Terry Bogard.
Nice
wow.
Right there. Oh, the missile though. Yeah. Oh my gosh, this could be a problem.
God.
This could be a serious problem. What is he going to do with this?
He might just kill.
Yeah, there's a soul fist assist.
That was pretty slick.
Hey. It's not enough. I don't think it's enough.
He's going to have that space to call that assist, though.
Oh, nice. My God. Just enough. Yeah, you were right. And also combined with the uppercut, he has to get to Doom before he DHCs. They didn't get to him. And this gives essentially Chris G one more chance. Oh my gosh.
Oh.
Strider got caught.
Wow. Just like that, it got grim.
Okay.
Oh,
I missed him put again. Oh, but he gets hit. Okay, he has one more chance. Here we go, folks. This is Terry Bogard's last chance.
The best thing he could do right now is just go for the Doom Kill. Oh my god, stop calling him like that. Oh, he should go for it right here. Oh!
Start with the missiles. Oh my god.
The scramble.
X-Factor's running out. If you're gonna do something, you have to do it right now.
Oh my god. Just go for a stinger real quick. Oh my
god,
he actually did hit.
He tried to mix up. He tried to do download teleport. And for that,
gets punished, and Chris G takes it 3-1, folks. Wow.
That was good stuff by both. That was an excellent match.
Yes, absolutely. A little preview, a little taste of what we're going to see later on in this tournament, folks.
Yep, yep, yep. And Terry Bogard, still confident. He gives him his props.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Good, good acknowledgement there of the good gameplay.
Yes. Definitely. Wow, wow.
Yeah, that was very unfortunate for Terry, man. It got into that scramble situation. Chris G got the happy boo-boo, and he loses his he loses his health lead.
Yeah, this could have gone totally the opposite way. With that game that he decided to teleport.
Wow, is this for real? That's this for real, right here?
Captain America.
No.
What?
No. Read that card. Look what it says.
Okay, I think that's the one thing we're gonna have to make an exception for.
Excuse me. Is that who's playing? I just want to know.
And with that, folks, I'm going to save you guys the mystery. I'm going to let IFC Yipes tell you guys this name. I must excuse myself because I have pools, sir.
Oh, you got it?
Yes. I have to go and play. So thank you, everybody, for giving me the opportunity to commentate.
Good luck, man. Yeah. I actually got to go soon, too.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. But in the meantime, I leave you guys with great hands. Stay tuned. Tell your friends about it. Mr. IFC.
Tweeted out. All right, and there goes Golden Boy Neo stepping off. Yeah, I'm actually have to step off myself, too. Yeah, no, one more match I'm in there. No, for sure. Tagging right in right now. Joining me is the sexiest white man I know. Jay, just so you know, you're a sexy individual, bro.
I look good. I know it.
Thank you. See, I ain't even had to say that. What's going on, Jay?
Not much. So we got one more before we're going to hand it off over to Melee.
Okay. Yeah, sweet. The Melee boys in the building. Okay. All right. So we've been having a lot of interesting names stepping up to the plate. Okay.
No.
TNP Cross taking on Captain America.
All right.
Y'all heard it here, folks. Y'all heard it here right, guys. Representing USA, Captain America.
Captain America. I bet this dude don't even play Captain America. I bet it's just a pun. He better play Captain America. I need to see it.
I don't think he plays Captain America. Oh, and if he does, he got to be Anchor. He got to play Anchor Captain America. All right, hold on. Let's see. Captain America. Nah. Wow, that was a troll name. Indeed. Good call. Definitely did not play Captain America. Wow, interesting. Zero.
If he's gonna do it as an anchor, I don't know. If you're gonna play Zero as an anchor, you need the uppercut, so you get the alpha counter into Sagenbu. So he's probably gonna switch it up.
Right. True. Okay. Cross really strong, man. I'm actually impressed with the gameplay. Wait a minute. Oh, Cross kicked this team. Oh, okay. Wow. Earlier he was playing DMC, so I guess he picks it maybe on dude-based team, stuff like that. That's pretty interesting. Wow. Right, here we go. Zero neutral.
All right, Bolt's helping out.
It's actually interesting. I've never seen this combination before like that.
Zero Bolts is actually kind of interesting. Not a lot of people play it, and I don't really know why.
And that's a strange commitment, man. I don't think they really want to commit to it, but the assist is great if you know how to really incorporate that to your game.
All right, yeah, tagging right back in.
Very nice.
Nice.
Okay, here comes the pickup. I will definitely go for the snap at this point. I'm pretty sure he's
gonna make
Virgil
in the back, definitely. Oh, all right.
Confident man. That's a confident man right there.
You can believe in your incoming quite a bit. But if you're going to let the devil rock, you better really believe.
You believe. Cross. Apparently, so I don't know if you've been hearing the word out there. Apparently, he is the best from Japan. I'm thinking it's RF.
Really? Yeah, the way I heard it was RF. But
yeah, so Nemo and RF agree that he is the guy to beat in Japan.
All right. Well, we're seeing it right now.
But interesting. I'm liking the team composition. He actually picked out the strings. Certain matches, yeah, because I'd be comfortable with the Strange Assist just off a Doom-based team, so that's probably why he put it on his team.
Can I have all the Guilty Gear judges?
Yep. Do you play, what type do you play?
I play it too, so I'm right after this match, I get
right
on over.
Okay, cool. Good luck.
Thank you.
So it's a long road. Get back up there. All right, who's next? So this is a game of red lights, green lights. That was kind of left with an advantage there, but right back to it. All right, the pressure's on. Sean's got the. You know how this matchup works the most is whoever gets the box in first. You know.
Right.
That's one of the best ways to play this matchup from what I've seen. I rarely see these mirror matches unless I see like Flux Cloud.
Yeah, because both these heroes have a full screen assist. Cross has the bolts, and Captain America has the missiles. They both kind of want to keep their distance right here, so it is kind of opposite for most Zero matchups based around jam session, just trying to get in and get across them. These guys are actually trying to outplay each other instead of getting dumb.
This is true. This is true. Nice to see them play. Captain America doing some great work.
Nice.
Captain America. He's definitely putting in some work right now. Definitely crossing.
Yeah, no meter needed.
Let's see. Are you a god or are you human?
Okay. Ooh.
Ooh, that could have gotten very, very slippery. So Captain America, though, he recovers and he survives.
Yeah, and he keeps his X Factor, so Virgil's in the back feeling real good right now.
I know he is desperately looking for that slither of meter right now. There we go.
Here it comes.
He's in here. El Diablo. Good evasive maneuver there by Cross.
Ooh. Yeah, those bolts saving lives right there. That was a Helmbreaker on deck. Yikes. Nice timing.
Okay, here we go. The mix-up. Oh, Dr. Strange, do whatever you want. Show no respect.
Ooh.
Guy with the classic. Classic's always good.
Double up. Okay. Good snap.
Clean.
Yeah, Captain America, he's out of meters, so he's going to have to let this rock.
Good. As long as he keeps this a one-on-one and he doesn't call no assists, he should win this.
Yeah, time is becoming a factor. We're at 21 seconds left. Yeah, Cross really has to make something happen right now. Oh, here we go.
That'll definitely kill. Double trigger boosting it up.
Last hit.
Oh my goodness.
All right, one block.
Why not? Oh, nice shit there.
Nice. Wow,
nice S.
Yeah, Captain America, he's just blocking right now. He's not even trying to land hit.
Okay.
You're out of time.
That could have actually worked out, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, you know what? Just in time, though. Score is now 1-1, I believe.
Yes.
Okay. He might
just
go back.
Yeah, Captain America, he's smiling to himself. He knows he got away with a little bit there. He parked the bus a little early.
And Cross out to stay with the Dr. Strange team. I think I would have still made cry by then. But it's time.
Yeah, that's his main team. Oh, here we go.
The pickup.
Yeah, that's a really good adjustment. That's actually hard to hit on both characters like that.
Oh, okay.
Nice. The sneaky cross up, the low one.
Man, what an efficient cross. I mean, he's going to get the job done. If he cares about moving on, he is going to finish this. And I'm assuming this is the winner's final side of things, too.
Yes, I believe it is.
It is. Okay. All right, taking the time to breathe real quick. I think he's going to pick Captain America now. Not at all.
No.
Interesting to see the Zero Mirror. Cross definitely on top of things.
Yeah, one of the things I'm noticing, I kind of thought that what Cross would do is he'd wait for the missiles and then counter call with Doctor Strange, but he's allowing Captain America to have missiles out because he wants to save those bolts for a full screen confirm off of the level 3 buster.
Yep.
That is
so that's interesting. So he's just allowing Captain America to get set up. It's a dangerous game, but it's working.
Yeah.
So.
And the fact that, and Cross is actually showing respect to Captain Buster as well.
Yeah.
Interesting. You know, it's actually one of the only times I actually catch this character like very interesting in this matchup particularly.
Yeah.
And a good Magneto, of course, but this is very interesting. Yeah. That's actually why I'm kind of surprised that Cross picked Dr. Strange. The bucket could just cleave right through. Uh-oh.
Adjustment to keep two. Very nice. Oh, he didn't have his buster built up, and that...
That might just bite him.
That is a huge reversal.
Momentum shift immensely right here. Nice. Mixed it up.
Oh,
man.
He dropped two.
I'm going to have to buy some time here so you can bring out Virgil.
Yeah, he's fully loaded, so Virgil will have a lot to play with here.
If I was brave like that, then I would definitely crown him right now at this point.
Watch for the hard tag. He didn't do it. He didn't bite. That, I like that.
Uh-oh.
Caught him back dashing. I don't even think he needed that X. Like, he's betting it all on this mix-up right here. Cross-up to block. Ooh!
That actually would have been good, but it was too fast, nonetheless. The benefits of level 2 X-Factor
wow.
Virgil. Oh, best to save them. We could get a tie game here. Hold on. Okay, nice move there by Cross, boarding the missiles. Ooh, nice break there.
Nice. Adjusting for missiles, couldn't hold it up long enough.
Nice grab.
Oh.
He got a little too greedy there. I don't know what he was looking for. He might have tried to do a teleport maybe. Launch the teleport.
Okay. And he gets away.
Oh, okay.
It was a double snap, yeah.
Oh, I was about to say. I thought it was a glitch. I actually didn't catch that. Blink.
All right, one block. He makes the block. And that's a chip out unless he can, yeah. Couldn't get it out. All right, so it's 2-2.
Man, best thing Carlos could have done there, just a try, would have been a snapback, but. All right, now he's going to go to the Zero Man Grind.
Wow. Oh, he's sticking with this the whole way through.
This is very weird, man. I must say, Volt does not do good against Zero, period. But I see why he's using it. But I don't know.
Like he really believes in those full screen confirms. But I mean, he's only got it once.
The
other time was kind of a scramble situation.
Training room. Okay, 2-2. Who will advance to the winner side of things? I'm rooting for the fat. The cross though, very strong, for sure. Okay. They both slowing down the face right now. They know what's at stake right here.
Yeah, this means too much. Ooh, the throw, I hear missiles. Are they coming? There they are.
Oh, dropped it, but it's okay though. Still got good control of the match.
Ooh, cross up S.
Wow. Wow. What an unfortunate situation here for the American. Lost pretty much the heart of the team there.
Yeah. Oh, that's
wow.
Gross.
The layers. Okay.
Yeah, he's not snapping. He's just going 1-2-3 on these kills.
Confident on incoming.
Ooh.
Man,
save
man.
The meter, I love it.
Oh, he made a block. You get dangerous.
Wow! Can't stop the shadow. Shadow always comes out.
We'll get an X Factor to the super. And Cross advances. Man, oh man, good stuff there. Someone's with the Frieza, man. I respect it though. Shout out to Japan. They definitely came to play.
Yeah, they came strong, and Cross is moving on. I think another one of them is still moving on, and you still got RF in your pool at 4 o'clock. So Team Japan is in the building.
Definitely in the building. So okay, I think we're gonna step up here.
Okay.
Oh, okay. So, So it's going to be streamed right here?
No. So what's coming up next is we got Melee coming up next here.
Okay.
And Marvel will come back between 4 and 6 on SRK Evo 6. So that's twitch.tv/SRK Evo 6. And for people who are watching the stream who are actually here, that's right over there. So.
Okay. All right.
All right.
Sure.
And then quarters and semis will be back here on SRK Evo 2 from 6. SRK Evo 2 and 3. Okay. Yeah. So between 6 and 8. And then semis will be from 8 until we're done. Until we're done.
Okay. So definitely stay tuned to that Melee action. I'm ISC Yipes.
Jay Snyder.
Okay. We signing out, man.
We're
peace and love. We'll be back.